Dearest Lance, thank you for your wonderful letter. I thoroughly enjoyed it. The contents were well constructed, and I very much enjoyed your analogy of the return of Lance versus the fall of the father. It is also reassuring that you are concerned to an extent with the marital problems of your problem-plagued parents, as you stated. It is even more rewarding, however, to know that at times in your and my relationship that you did feel close to me and that you did consider me a father friend and not always as a horrible money-dispensing crocodile. You say you're going to enter the competitive grind so you'll be accomplished and successful. Well, Lance, that really isn't too important to me. I think you should take some further formal training to prepare yourself to support yourself. But whether you come to visit me as a famous movie star or as a broken-down insurance salesman, it won't make 1 ounce of difference what you have accomplished, because I know you have tried every day to the fullest measure and that you have brought happiness and cheer to everyone that you meet, and that you go through life with that charming, gay, fascinating personality and with style. And so when you come to see me during our future life, come and see me as a very good old friend who just wants to enjoy you and who you want to enjoy, and that, my boy, is a real-life father and son relationship. But back to the marital split subject. I really have no desire to return home. Loneliness is not one of my problems. And I truly want to see if I can forge a new life for myself that I have considered for some time. For the past few years, I think Patty and I more or less targeted the summer of 1972 as a time for the split, a time when the boys graduated from high school. So you might say that the termination came a little early. Many people say that it is silly to continue a marriage because of the children, but I honestly believe that the whole family should remain together until the children are capable of taking care of themselves. Your mother is the most difficult to forsake. She is truly the only person I ever really loved with my entire heart and soul. She's a completely honest woman with an honesty that makes her very beautiful to me. She has been my rock of Gibraltar, both as a snug harbor of security and also as a perilous navigation hazard for 20 years. I adore the ground she walks on, and I love living with her. But at the same time, I guess it's the famous American social custom: marriage requires 100% attention and devotion to duty, a living style of all or nothing at all. We must be together in all things. I can't understand how we American people can get ourselves into this togetherness practice. Actually, I think it's a ridiculous situation that the family is breaking up. I really think it's probably that Patty and I have annoyingly been working on it for about 5 years. Anyway, right now, maybe it's like the lemmings walking to the sea. How can we explain everything we do? Why did I have 5 fine children? Why did we move to Santa Barbara? Just how much control do we have over our destiny? It's just too tough to keep fighting to keep everything together and try to keep everyone happy and calm down. So that's the way it is. Take care of yourself, and don't take any wooden nickels. Love, Dad.